Eric Sachs here today to talk to you a little bit about the shoulds in your life. If you're sitting there watching this video right now, tell me if there's something you have thought you should be doing in the last week. I'm definitely one of them. And this all came about a couple years ago when life was getting kind of crazy. I woke up one morning, things seemed to be almost out of control. I have family obligations, I have business obligations, I'm managing a real estate company, I'm doing my own real estate transactions. You know, in the afternoon I had to get my son to Taekwondo, my daughter to dance, my son from Taekwondo back to dance, and shit, I forgot my daughter at dance. I know we've all been there. So, you know, as we got through this, and I'm working with agents on the other side that are difficult to work with, maybe a jerk agent on the other side. I know some of you have dealt with that in this business. And the agents are calling me for questions from the company. I didn't know where to get started. And I sat in my office and I said to myself, I should call that client that emailed me last week and I should get a newsletter out. But you know what? Things are super busy right now. And in 2 weeks, I'm gonna be okay. Dance will be over, I'll close two deals and I'll get those shoulds done. And how do you think that worked for me? 2 weeks rolled around and I was just as busy today as I'm gonna be tomorrow. And I told myself, oh, in two more weeks, the dance will be over and I'm closing two more deals and I'll be able to get to those shoulds that are on my list and I'll get those done. But all of a sudden, 6 months rolled around and I'm sitting with my business partner. We're in our office and we're looking at our pipeline and it looks dismal. We had nothing coming up. And it's because I kept saying to myself, I should do this and I should do that. And I didn't get any of my shoulds done. And Nathan and I sat there and we said, you know what? Should is a bad word. We're not gonna use should anymore. We have to use have or need, but not should. And it's really funny, a year or so later in one of our practices, we call our sales meetings practices at the company that we own. And I had an agent say to us as we were talking about shoulds, I post above my computer, I shall not should on myself. I died laughing, but then I started thinking about it. It's fantastic. I named my class after that. I shall not should on myself. And that's what we're doing. We're shoulding on ourselves when we say we should do something and we don't do it. I should get a newsletter out to my sphere. And I have a pretty big sphere, so I should get a clear, consistent newsletter out. I should do open houses. I should do contact business owners in my area and trying to find out if they're hiring people so that I could be their relocation person. I should do rent versus buy postcards so I can get that out to the renters in the area and get some deals out of that. And I should do a first-time home buyer seminar. So those are five shoulds on my list. And let's see what my goals from these shoulds are. Obviously, we're doing these for a reason. I want to get some deals. So from my newsletter, I think I can get 10 transactions in 2012 out of my newsletters. I think I can get five from open houses, five renters deciding to buy homes, five first-time home buyers from my seminars, and five buyers from my businesses that I'm going to talk to. So overall, that's 30 transactions that were sitting on my desk, not getting done when I was shooting on myself. But let's put some money to it right now. 30 transactions in my area, let's say $200,000 is the average sales price where I sell real estate. And the average commission is about 3%. So the average take-home commission is, let's say, $6,000. So if I am leaving 30 transactions on the table times $6,000, I'm walking away from $180,000 in sale and commission income. So if you put some dollar signs to what you're missing out on, it makes it clear in your head what we're leaving on the table. One of the things that we found out helped is a little thing that Nathan came up with, 90 times 10 equals zero. And I'm glad Nathan came up with that because that's kind of my math, 90 times 10 equals zero. But let's talk about that. If you've got five things that you're on your should list and you start your newsletter, you get it 90% done. You start your rent versus buy postcard, you get that 90% done. You wanna do a class and you get your outline and maybe even a date set, but you never get it done. You get things 90% done, but you never finish it. So 90 times 10 equals zero. You got nothing done, you have zero from it. So compartmentalize, that's really what we're talking about here. Take your should, take your need, do it one thing at a time. Take one thing, get it 100% done, and you have something. The next thing I wanna talk about is accountability. For the most part in this industry, we're all independent contractors, right? So in essence, we're small business owners. Who are we accountable to? Really not our brokers. you know, hopefully, maybe a little bit. But accountability is super difficult in our profession. So find accountability. I'm lucky, I've got a business partner. So when I say I'm gonna get a newsletter done and I have to show up the next day and look at Nathan in the eyes and say, I didn't get it done. I get that feeling in my gut, in my stomach, that I let somebody down. Finding an accountability group, a partner, your broker, a coach, I don't care what it is, find some accountability in your life so that when you say you need to do something, that you're gonna get it done. We realize that the shoulds on our list are costing us money. We're walking away from money. We're leaving it on the table. We realize that we don't want to do things 90% of the way. We want to compartmentalize, get them done 100%. And we want to find some accountability in our business life so that we get things done and we're accountable to somebody. If we do those things, I'm sure you're going to have a great year in 2012. Go out and sell some homes. I'm Eric Sachs with BreakthroughBroker.com. Looking forward to seeing you again.